to Gore Point. Gale warning. Northeast wind 30 knots increasing to northeast 40 knots Friday afternoon. Diminishing to southeast 15 knots Friday night. Sea 7 feet building to 12 foot Friday afternoon. Sea subsiding to east.
Well, I do some surf tours up here in Alaska, and kind of the Montague Cup is the same thing I do all summer, spring and fall, with taking people out on my boat and surfing places on Montague Island here, and fishing and hunting and beachcombing, and this is just kind of the end of the year celebration, everybody getting together, a lot of people that go with me throughout the year, and having a little get together and spend some time together and have a little fun contest.
Right, right.
For all the people out there who want to get some information on the Montague Cup, how to get in it, and what it's all about, and this and that, where can they get that information?
Oh, they can just call Borderline there in the Diamond Center, 349-9931. And, you know, if they want to get more information about surfing Alaska, too, just call there, and they have a lot of information, or they can give you my number. And,
all right. So what's the biggest waves you've ever seen out here in Alaska? And when I come out here, people are like, dude, you got to wear a dry suit and all this. So what is the story, dude? How big are the waves and what kind of stuff you need?
Oh, they get big. I mean, they get like Hawaii out here. A lot of people don't realize it, but they get 15, 20-foot faces. And with the Montague Cup, we haven't been real lucky as having waves during the contest. It always seems like right before the contest they're real big, or right after the contest, but I got a feeling tomorrow we got a little swell coming in, and I think this might be the first year out of 3 years that we have some good sized waves for the finals, so that'll be pretty neat.
Nice, I hope so. Alright, that's it with Scott. If you want to go surf in Alaska, give him a call over at Borderline and go check him out. We'll be seeing you.
They're brothers. They shot the big buck again. They got him right here. How long were you guys out yesterday hunting?
Probably
12 hours.
12 hours?
Yeah. 7 to 7, 7 to 8, almost 13.
Yeah.
Were you going to spend the night if that's what it took?
Yeah.
We weren't planning on it, but yeah, I guess, I don't know, we were going to try and make it back if we got lost. So.
Who actually pulled the trigger on that bad boy?
I did, yeah.
Killer.
Yeah.
How'd that all turn out? You just seen him, he jumped out in front of you and just blasted him, or were you eating grass pretending you were a deer?
No, we kind of watched the same deer all day, and we jumped up a mature buck, but never saw him again, so we knew the spike was there, so we kind of crawled down next to him and got a really close shot, made sure it was a spike, and then shot him.
See, you guys will be back next year?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Absolutely. All right.
So yeah, you guys the only ones that ever got any deer around here, dude. The rest of us kind of lazy, you know?
It's a lot of work, man.
All right, Will and Kevin,
yeah.
They're the big buck champions, this year's Montague Cup. Cup skeet shooting champion Tony Mann,
and we're here also with 2003 Montague Cup biggest silver AKJ.
All right, Tony, now shooting skeet, you were out there, you crinkled them in the second round. Now, were you practicing over the winter or anything like that, or what's the deal?
Well, I'll tell you, usually the only thing I'm shooting with shotguns are big furry things, so those little clay pigeons, that's all new to me. But man, I have a good time out here, and I just saw him this time. I'll tell you what, though. What I really want to know, okay, because I was kind of coming back for a little vengeance with the fishing thing, and I just want to know, what was your tactics as far as finding the holes, you know, first and getting there before everybody else?
Right. Well, you know, last year I went up to Big Bend Hole.
Mm-hmm.
It's right above Mosquito Rapid Hole. Right. And I went in there, and I was fishing, and boom, I caught this big fish. And I looked at it and like, wow, the fishing was so good. I'll just let that one go. I can catch a bigger one than that, right? And so I let that one go, and that was that I never even got a fish on the bank last year or one at the scales. So this year I'm like, dude, I'm going right back up to the hole. Everything's dying. I'm even pulling them out. They're going down. So I pull one out for a measuring stick. He was like 11 pounds. And then the next one, next cast, bam, is that 12 and a 3/4, tie your records.
Nice. And so that was when I saw you heading past me when I was just walking up to the holes. Uh-huh. And you had already burned them out and sword lift all my fish, and you were going back with a stringer on your back.
Well, you know, I hooked that fish and I'm like, that's the one. Got him on the beach. Slammed the Red Bull because it gives you wings. I needed some air freight back to the scale, and there I was.
So you're going to be back now. Really?
Now you are 2-year fishing champion.
That's right.
Two previous years. And then now you're skeet championing. Are you just going to round out your whole quiver there and maybe come on some surfing? And
last year when I was saying I was maybe a little Gretzky, I'm thinking maybe I'm a little Michael Jordan. Maybe I'll just mix up my fields in which I come and bring the balls home to the family, you know?
Right.
Yeah, I don't have too much hunting skills, but I could wear some camouflage with all these boys and go hunting up and down these hills.
Right, I hear you.
I could look for little nubulars too, I think.
Right.
Diversify my skills.
Right.
Do they
allow one-man teams?
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. I'm going to look into the rules a little deeper next year.
Sweet.
But you know what? It's so much fun hanging with all these guys and meeting all these new people. It's a good time over here at Lisk Land.
It is. You know, God created all this stuff, and I just enjoy just the moment or two to enjoy what he's made.
Amen.
That's what it's about.
That's what I'm saying.
Jake Liska here. Now, Jake, you've been in every Montague Cup?
Yep, every one.
One?
Dude, that's a pimpy earring you got going in your wetsuit, dude.
I know, when I was taking my hood off, it came out of my ear. So I left it there for good luck.
Now, who's carrying most of the weight on your team? Are you got a lot of weight on your back, or is somebody else carrying you?
No, I think I got a lot of weight on my back, and my boy Ashley Call's got a lot of weight on his back, too. We got two new rookies this year, Andre Spinelli and Matt Eastman. This is, they're both rookies, so, yeah, I'd say me and Ashley got a little weight to carry this year.
Nice, nice. All right, you got any, you want to thank any of your sponsors or anybody who got you here?
I'd just like to thank Scott Liskin, the Montague Cup. And I'll be here every year.
All right, Jake. Thanks a lot, bro. Yep. See you out in the surf. We got Andre Spinelli here. Now, we had Jake on a little while ago, and he said he was carrying you around on his back. What's up with that?
Yeah, well, he hasn't been giving me too good of a ride.
It's been a little bit like boiler and not pow, or what?
I don't know, man. If he's carrying me, I haven't really moved too much.
Hey, well, how's it? This is your first Montague Cup, you being a rookie now. How are you liking it? What's the experience like?
It's just a pretty nice place to come hang out.
Nice place to come hang
out.
Nice, relaxing, peaceful.
Yeah.
Right. Ancient days of mysterious ways, works wonders, setting bushes ablaze, 40 years in a maze with a pillar of fire, dancing on the waves, my life is I, who is like you, who was, is, and will be, who can do what you could do simply, he who has an ear, let him hear, speaking through your ears, my transmission clear.
Josh, thanks a lot, bro.
All right.
We'll be seeing you.
Good.